Hi guys, this is the Venkatesh Pillu. Welcome back to Sandeep English World. Today I am here to deal with the topic of yes or no type questions. In our day-to-day communication, we speak two types of questions. One is information questions and the other one is yes or no type questions. To know the formation of yes or no type questions, you should have the basic knowledge of the anomalous findings. In the language of English, there are 24 anomalous findings. How many hours are there in a day? 24. How many spokes are there in the wheel of Ashoka? 24. How many carats are there in pure gold? 24. So similarly, you can remember the number 24. Anomalous finites are 24. These anomalous finites are broadly divided into two. One is primary auxiliaries, the other is modal auxiliaries. Primary auxiliaries are 11 and modal auxiliaries are 13. Primary auxiliaries act as main verbs and helping verbs, whereas modal auxiliaries act as helping verbs only. And let me talk about the primary auxiliaries. Am, is, are, was, were, have, has, had, do, does, did. These are the primary auxiliaries. And what are the modal auxiliaries? Will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought, need, day, use. Really, if you are thorough with these 24 anomalous finites, you can speak beautiful English. You can go abroad and communicate by using only these 24 auxiliaries. You can manage in different situations by being familiar with these 24 anomalous finites. I enjoy memorizing or cherishing or saying these 24 anomalous finites with a single breath. Please wait and see. Yam, is, are, was, were, have, has, had, do, does, did, will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought, need, dare, used without any break. I have uttered. Why I am referring to all these things is, if you know the names of all these anomalous finites, you can know about the usage and formation of all these things. Not once with a single breath, but twice, I can say. Let me try once again. Yam, is, are, was, were, how, has, had, do, does, it, will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought, need, dare, use. Yam, is, are, was, were, how, has, had, do, does, it, will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought, need, dare, used. Twice I have uttered, in the sense, 48 words I have uttered with a single breath. It's a kind of exercise for making ourselves fluent in the words uttered by us. Now, my point is, if you want to pose yes or no type questions, you should have the basic knowledge of all these 24 anomalous finites. Every yes or no type question begins with one of these anomalous finites only. Now, let's take some examples. Example number one. I am the founder of Sandeep Educational Institutions. In the given statement, I is the subject and am is the verb. To change it into yes or no type question, we have to invert the subject and verb. We get am I. I am becomes am I. Am I the founder of Sandeep Educational Institutions? Next, example number two. Mr. Jagan is the CM of AP. In the given statement, Mr. Jagan is the subject and is the verb. To change it into yes or no type question, you have to invert the subject and the verb.
is Mr. Jagan the CM of AAP? And in the other example, boys are naughty. Boys is the subject and are is the verb. To change it into astronomical question, we have to invert the subject and the verb. Are boys naughty? Take the fourth example. You are going home. In the given statement, you is the subject and are is the helping verb. Here you find going as the main verb. The main verb doesn't move. The main verb is in its usual place. We have to simply invert the subject and the helping verb. Are you going home? This is the yes or not help question. And next example number 5. She is working in the bank. In the given statement, she is the subject and is the helping verb. Working is the main verb. The main verb does not change. Simply, we have to invert the subject and the helping verb. Is she working in a bank? Next example. Gopi was absent yesterday. This is the statement. Gopi is the subject and was is the verb. To make it a SR, not a question, we have to invert the subject and the verb. Was Gopi absent yesterday? Next, passing on to the seventh example. They were crazy about English. In the statement, they is the subject and were is the verb. To make it a sound what I have question, simply invert the subject and the verb. Were they crazy about English? Next, example number 8. Mr. Ramesh has passed the exam. Mr. Ramesh is the subject and has is the helping verb. Whereas passed is the main verb. The main verb will be in its usual place. Simply, we have to invert the subject and the helping verb. Has Mr. Ramesh passed the exam? Next, example number 9. The police have caught the thief. In the given statement, the police is the subject and have is the helping verb. Caught is the main verb. The main verb doesn't move anywhere. Simply, we have to invert the subject and the helping verb. Have the police caught the thief? This is the yes or no question. Next example. Mamata will marry her cousin. Mamata is the subject and will is the helping verb. Whereas marry is the main verb that remains in its usual place. To change it into yes or no question, simply invert the subject and the helping verb. Will Mamata marry her cousin? Next example. Example number 11. We shall take rest for today. In this sentence, we is the subject and shall is the helping verb. Whereas take is the main verb, it remains as it is. It doesn't change. To change it into yes or no question, we have to invert the subject and the helping verb. Shall we make? Shall we take a rest for today? And next example. Kavita can reach her goal. In this sentence, Kavita is the subject and can is the helping verb. Whereas reach is the main verb, it remains as it is. To invert this into a sonotype question, subject, we have to invert the subject and the verb. Then it becomes, can Kavita reach her goal? Next example. It may rain today. In the given sentence, it is the subject and may is the helping verb. To make it yes or no type question, simply invert the subject and the helping verb. May it rain today? And next, passing on to the other example. COVID-19 affects many people. This is the statement. Here, the subject, COVID-19 is the subject and affects is the verb. This sentence is different from the other examples you have seen just now. The verb in the given sentence is in simple pretense and the verb has yes also. In such cases, to change this type of sentences into yes or no type questions, simply we have to prefix does at the beginning and the verb yes is deleted from the given verb. Then the question is, does COVID-19 affect many people? Next example. They help one another. In the given statement, they is the subject and help is the verb. And in this sentence also, the verb is in simple pretense. In such cases, we have to simply prefix do at the beginning of the sentence so that we can get yes or no type question. Do they help one another? And next, one more example I would like to give you. Amar went to college yesterday. In this sentence, Amar is the subject and went is the verb. And the verb here is in simple past tense. Whenever you find the verb in simple past tense, to change that into yes or no type question, simply prefix did at the beginning of the sentence and the main verb in simple past tense is changed into simple plain tense as go. Then the question becomes, did Amar go to college yesterday? These are all some of the examples. And that's the end of the topic. And I hope that you have enjoyed this topic in a beautiful manner. If you like this video, you can subscribe to our channel and share this video with your friends and relatives. Thank you very much. Make a marvelous day.